So back in August, I made a video called How I Take Instagram Pics by Myself. And I asked at the end of that video, would you guys like a video on how I edit my Instagram photos? Everybody in the comments was like, yes, that would be incredibly helpful. I said, that sounds great. Let me forget to make this video for 8 f***ing months. So here it is, very overdue, how I edit my Instagram photos. Before we jump into the editing, I wanted to talk about how I take my Instagram photos because it has changed a little bit since 8 months ago, as one might expect. So back then I was taking photos on my DSLR, which I'm filming on right now, but I'll put like a photo of it here. It's the Lumix GH5, but honestly, I feel like in the past year, the DSLR look has kind of gone out of style, and now I honestly just like taking photos on my iPhone. I know that sounds counterintuitive because you think the more you spend on the camera, the better the photo will be, but I'm kind of over that like professional, blurry background, headshot type look, and I really just like how candid, as cringy as that sounds, iPhone pics look, and obviously it's easy to take photos wherever you go. I always take my iPhone photos in direct sunlight because for some reason the iPhone does something really good to your skin when you're standing right in the sun, and during sunset, of course, golden hour, everybody knows, makes your skin look beautiful, even if you're very much on your period struggling with hormonal acne like I am. Also, when I'm not on my period, that's more just a year-round struggle for some of us. I edit all of my photos on Lightroom CC, which is a free app to download on your phone. Now this is a lot more advanced than like Visco, some of those easy filtering apps, so it took me a while to learn, but finally, like 8 months later, I'm gonna show you guys what I have learned. By the way, I did finally develop preset packs, so if you guys do wanna buy my presets, I'm gonna link them in the description box below. I tried to make them really, really affordable. So if you wanna easily be able to apply a filter and make it look like my photos, then feel free to buy those. But otherwise, I'm gonna show you guys how to edit these photos completely from scratch today because I don't wanna be like one of those annoying YouTubers who's like, buy my presets, that's all the useful information I'm giving you. Like, I'm gonna actually teach you like the skills behind Lightroom, but you can also buy my presets if you would like. Here is our lovely photo, plain and simple, before any edits. This was taken on my iPhone in the sunlight. See what I was saying, by the way, about this glow on my skin? Like, only an iPhone does that shit. So first, let's take a look at the light section. Now, I'm really over that overexposed Instagram look, and I actually prefer something that's a little bit more dark and contrasty and cinematic, like the film student that I am, so I'm bringing down the exposure. Before I fine tune the rest of the light settings like contrast, highlights, shadows, whites, blacks, I'm gonna head over to the curve section. Now, if you haven't used Lightroom before, you're probably like, what the fuck is this? And trust me, I was the same way. I was so confused what any of these curves did, but they really are the most powerful part of Lightroom and the part that's gonna give you the most control over the look of your photo. So here is a quick explanation of what all of these curves do. All the way over on the right, all the way over on the left. I nearly failed my driver's license exam because I didn't know which direction was left and right, so 4 years later, I'm apparently having the same problem. So all the way over on the left is your shadows. So if you bring this up, it's gonna overexpose them, and a lot of people like bringing up the shadows a little bit to give it that faded aesthetic. Now I like to keep mine contrasty, so I'm gonna leave the shadows right down there where they are. In the middle, as one might expect, we have the midtones. So this is gonna bring them darker and bring them lighter. And at the right, we have the highlights, which will bring down the lightest tones, or you can bring them back up. So the x-axis goes from shadows to highlights in your photos, and the y-axis is how exposed they are. I don't mess with this too much, but I do bring down the highlights just a little bit. The next three tabs have those same graphs, except they're isolated by colorway. So we have a graph for red, a graph for green, and a graph for blue. So for example, on this red graph, the x-axis similarly goes from shadows to midtones to highlights, except this time the y-axis doesn't control how dark or light these tones are, they control how red or green the colors are. So if we bring up these midtones, for example, we're adding red to the midtones, which makes them very red. You can do this for like a very dramatic pop arty look, and if we bring them down, it's gonna make them a lot greener. These curves are where I like to play around a lot, and we're gonna start by adding some green to the shadows. I find that for iPhone photos, the shadows tend to get a little unsaturated, they look kind of dull, and I want to add a lot of richness back to the shadows, so we're going to add some green to the shadows in the red curve. We're counterintuitively also going to add some red to the shadows in the green curve. I find that if you go to two opposite colors, so red and green are opposite, for example, and you bring both of them down in a similar pattern, so we've added both green and red to the photo, it'll kind of cancel each other out and overall just create an oversaturated look on the shadows, if that makes sense. So this technique is saturating the shadows without oversaturating the rest of the photo, because I don't want, like, my skin, for example, to look crazy Oompa Loompa orange, but I want the shadows to look really, really rich. And next, we're gonna go into the blues, since my shadows are looking a tad too blue right now, and bring them down a bit to even out the whole photo. The key with these curves is really just playing around with them a lot. I hope my explanation made sense, but the best thing to do is to just download Lightroom, get your hands on it, and get playing around with the colors. Next, I'm heading over to the mid-tone slash highlight section, and I'm doing very, very subtle changes because this is the part that affects my skin tone. I'm adding a little bit of red so my skin tone looks a bit more accurate. Back in the light section, our curves left the photo looking a little bit dark in the shadows, so I'm going to the shadows, and bringing them up a bit. Here is how it looks right now. Here is how the original photo looked. So just with those curves and the light section of Lightroom, you can be making a lot of changes. This looks, look at that difference. Next, let's dive into the color section. So here we can control the temperature and tint of the photo. This basically controls how yellow or how blue the photo is. This section is particularly useful if, you know, you took a photo inside in fluorescent lighting, in your bathroom. We all love a good bathroom mirror selfie. Those tend to look a little yellow, so you can bring the temperature towards blue in order to cancel it out. The white balance on this photo is pretty good already, but it's a little bit green to me, so I'm going to add some of these pink tones in. I also tend to like a warmer look to my photos, but all up to your own choice. Next, let's head over to the mix section, which gives you even more fine-tuned control over how your colors look. The mix section of Lightroom basically lets you isolate a specific type of color and control how bright or how dark it is, what the tint is, how saturated it is, which can be great for perfecting the look of your photo and giving it a more like filtered look. First, I'm gonna approach the reds in this section, which obviously controls your lip color and also controls the shadows of your skin because they read as like red in Lightroom for some reason. So I like to bring the luminance down on that to give me kind of like a faux lipstick look. The truth is I never wear lipstick in real life, but I always just bring down the luminance on the reds in my photos and it makes me look like I'm wearing a nice red lip. On this top bar, you can change the hue. So you can change the red from this pinker tone to an oranger tone all the way on the other side. I never go too extreme with this, but I'm just gonna adjust it a little bit orange. Next, we've got the orange slider, which is, for me, the part that controls my skin tone. So you can make yourself look like an Oompa Loompa or Donald Trump. So if you're going crazy on filters or effects, do all of those first, then go to Lightroom, take a look at your orange slider, and correct your skin tone for what's accurate in real life. Because people are gonna notice if your skin tone is like looking really wild. So I'm gonna bring down the saturation a little bit. Another great way to use the sliders is to basically create a unified color palette in your photos by bringing them more extremely to one end or the other. So for example, there is some blue in the background of my photo, and there's also blue on my pants, but they're not exactly the same shade of blue. By bringing this blue hue slider to one side or the other, I can basically create a unified color for all of my blues in this photo, if that makes sense. So I'm gonna bring this more towards the purple side, and now the blue in the background matches the blue in my pants. You guys always ask me, like, how do you find buildings that match your outfit exactly? And this is the secret. They generally don't match my outfit perfectly, but I can change these sliders so that the colors end up looking perfect once they're in my photo, so. Oh, spicy little secret there. Now the sun is hitting the edge of this window and it's making it pretty bright, which I find distracting from me, who's supposed to be the center of the photo. So I am going to go into the blue slider and bring down the luminance so that highlight kind of fades away and I am still the center of attention. Oh god, that's the most YouTuber-y shit I've ever said. And now for the effects tab. I'm gonna click on split tone. The split tone section allows you to individually change the colors of the highlights. So you can make them green, you can make them blue, and the shadows. So obviously I don't go too crazy with this, but I think I'm gonna give the shadows a little bit of a red tint. I spent the next 10 minutes fine-tuning those color curves and the color mix section. This for me is really different in each photo, so I'm just making tiny, tiny adjustments until it looks just right. I also added a little bit of grain for a vintage effect. So after about an hour of editing, here is our before, and here is our after. For some people, this isn't like that dramatic of an edit, but I always just want to enhance the colors that are already in the photo, make it look a little bit more cohesive and cinematic, but not go super crazy filtered. This is a much uglier photo to start out with, so we're gonna have to really go hard on the edit in order to make it worth post it on the Instagram. that was weird. Okay, the first problem with this photo is obviously that it is underexposed. You can barely even see the features on my face, so that's something that I want to fix right away. I'm going to jump into the light section and bring up the exposure a bit, and also bring up the shadows. Now the shadows feature on Lightroom is a freaking godsend. Look at how much that changed. You can see my face, you can see the details on my outfit. It looks like such a better photo already. All right, let's jump into the curve. Especially because we've brought up the shadows on this photo, the shadows are looking quite unsaturated. So just like last time, I'm bringing the shadow section down on each of the color curves to give it a little bit more of a saturated look and just playing around with which tone I want to shine through in the shadows. Next, I'm bringing the temperature closer to the yellow end because I really want this photo to have a sunnier look to it, if that makes sense. And it was looking a little bit sad. Hopping into mix, let's play around with these blues a little bit. Like I mentioned last time, I want the blues on the building to match the blues in my outfit. And I also just want the colors to pop. So I'm bringing up the saturation on the blue. Since my face is in shadow, I'm gonna bring the orange luminance up a little bit to lighten up my skin tone and make my facial features easier to see. Same thing in the red section, so my face looks a little bit less contrasty and harsh. A lot of the times this mix section is just a lot of me playing around. In each photo, the sections that each color controls are different. So for example, on this yellow, I'm just gonna like slam luminance to either side and see what it affects. And it looks like it's affecting the background of the photo. So if I want that super bright, clean background look, I could totally bring the luminance all the way up. But I actually want a little bit more dimension to my photo. I want those shadows to stand out. So I'm gonna bring the luminance down and bring the yellows towards the orange side so it kind of completes the warm toned theme of this photo. The greens are obviously gonna control the bushes behind me. So I'm just gonna play around with that until I get them to my liking. I think I'm gonna bring the luminance down. With all of the color done, the photo still looks rather harsh and contrasty, so I'm gonna hop into the curve section and flatten our entire color curve. This is a good technique if your photo is looking super contrasted. You wanna bring down the highlights and bring up the shadows so that the whole photo looks a little bit more evenly exposed. To finish up the photo, here is a little hack that I use when I'm taking my own outfit photos. I took this like literally with my phone balanced in somebody else's car door handle, so the angle was not the most ideal. So I go into geometry. The distortion slider basically allows you to create a wider angle look on your photo without having a fancy wide angle lens. So if you slide it a little bit this way, or a lot of it this way, you see how it creates this like dramatic wide angle effect? It can make your legs look longer, it can make your photo look more dynamic. This is why fashion photographers often use a very wide angle lens, but if you don't have one and you're just taking it on your iPhone, you can kind of cheat it with the distortion effect. If your photo was taken on a tilt, you can also go in with vertical, and if you slide it this way, it basically fakes that look like somebody took your photo from below and it makes your legs look longer. I'm not gonna go too crazy with the vertical on this one because I think if you push it too far, like you can look a little bit ridiculous. So I'm just gonna leave it as is. When I change up the geometry, I'll always click on constrain crop, which basically gets rid of this like weird gray border at the sides and make sure that your photo is cropped properly. Here is the original photo looking like a spicy pile of trash. And here is our edited photo, looking like a hot piece of trash. Oh yeah. Lastly, I wanted to talk to you guys about how I plan my Instagram feed. Now, I'm not like a crazy planner because I feel like there's better things to do in life than figure out what fucking order squares go in on your Instagram feed. But I do like to make sure that it looks okay at least. So I use the app Plann. This is a free app on the App Store as well. It basically allows you to look at your Instagram feed and what you've already posted and add some new photos that you're thinking about posting and drag them around and see what order they would look best in. My main rule for building an aesthetic feed, oh, that's so cringy. My main rule for planning my Instagram feed is to make sure that I change up the background or dominant color in my photos. So for a while when my Instagram feed was like really, really ugly, my main pitfall was that every single one of my photos was taken against like a white or cream background. And then it looked really, really boring. So I've been trying to take a lot more photos against colored walls, against a sky for that bold blue, against grass for a green color, and making sure I disperse light and dark and colorful and plain backgrounds throughout my feed so that it creates this really like pleasing colored square effect. Or if you're not a colorful type of person, just changing it up between a dark background and a light background can create a lot of contrast between your photos and create a much better looking feed. Alrighty, that is pretty much how I do it. How the magic is done, kids. Again, if you don't want to bother with all of that shit that I taught you, my presets are also for sale. Oh god, I feel like such a YouTuber. But yeah, you can buy my presets if you want. I worked really hard on them. I think they're really good. Otherwise, I really hope I gave you guys the tools to develop your own presets and your own style. I feel like photo editing can be really intimidating to start out with, but I promise you, once you get the hang of it, you will be killing it. I will see you guys next week. Thank you guys so much for watching. Bye.